neighbors. Everybody needs good neighbors with a little understanding. You can find the perfect blend. Neighbors should be there for one another. That's when good neighbors become
We saw all the furniture going. We thought you must have agreed to it.
Listen to this. Dear Des, I have listed the things I have taken. They all belong to me. At least you and your lady friend still have a bed. Lorraine.
What happened?
Lorraine happened.
That's what you brought me here for, isn't it? Sex.
Yeah, and I'm a school rapist.
See a doctor to go on the pill.
The pill? Why?
Because this has never happened to me before, that's why.
Did he put you on the pill?
He took me out of it.
Have you eaten?
No. What happened here?
I'll tell you over dinner.
I'd love to see Desi's face when he sees that furniture.
I wish I could have seen Max's face when that second van pulled up.
Don't, Helen. You know how Max feels about this street. The poor girl hasn't done him a bit of harm, and he just goes on about having a stripper in Ramsey Street.
He told me his grandfather would turn in his grave.
Hi, Grant. Oh. Mrs. Ramsey.
Hello. Yeah, have a nice day.
Hi, Paul.
Yeah, great.
If you're hungry, go to the fridge.
Where is everyone?
Your father is next door helping Mr. Ramsey. Your little sister Lucy is upstairs asleep. Your older sister Julie has gone away for the week. And your brother Scott is out for dinner.
I had to ask dinner. Mm.
And you also missed the excitement in the Clark household.
What do you mean, Des?
Lorraine arrived this morning and took all the furniture.
What?
Just left them with the carpets, the curtains and Daphne's bed.
Oh, what a lousy trick. I tell you, that guy doesn't realise how lucky he was when she dumped him.
We can't see if there's anything
else. Yeah. Take a pot of jam.
I'm sure this will really cheer him up.
I know I should have told him about the new furniture, but he's always playing practical jokes on me.
I told you I'm not hungry.
I just don't believe this. I go to all this trouble to refurnish the house, and what do I get? Abuse.
I did not abuse you, Daphne. It's just that I can't accept that furniture, that's it.
I'm not asking you to accept it. It's under my name, and it'll be my responsibility. And if I decide to move out, which could well be this evening, I'll take the damn lot with me.
Oh, great. Great. Can you imagine the neighbours if another van load is shifted?
So, now you're worried about the neighbours.
I'm not worried about the neighbours.
Yo, anyone home?
No.
Sorry I wasn't here this afternoon. Grandma told me about Lorraine. They told me all your furniture is...
Is this a joke or something?
You tell me.
And what are you sulking like that for?
I'm not sulking.
Yes, you are. Lorraine took all the furniture when we were both out. I managed to replace everything, and Des doesn't like it.
You don't like it? It looks fantastic. In fact, it looks better than it did before. You're mad, you know that.
Have you finished?
Oh, no. Grandma gave me this jar of jam. And if you're not eating that chicken, I wouldn't...
I'm going for a walk.
Okay, see ya.
I honestly thought he'd be over the moon when he saw all this stuff.
Oh, he'll be okay.
How can you say that? I've been here less than 2 days and we've had a row already.
Ah, Des enjoys a good row. He's also very independent. Look, when he realised he couldn't afford to get married unless Lorraine chipped in, it hurt him. No, true, it really hurt him. And then she dumped him on the day of the wedding and capped it all off by taking his furniture back. He's just a bit sensitive about trusting another woman, that's all.
I was only trying to make things better for him.
Oh, you are. He just hasn't realised it yet.
I never eat this jam, you know.
Oh, that's great. I'm making Maria's jam for the fete, and she hasn't even tasted her own recipe.
That's my mother's recipe.
Oh, what the hell are you meant to do it now? He told me to do it.
Oh, leave it.
I can do it.
Leave it. Get out of here and put the kettle on, okay?
I never knew it so loud over here.
Poor Danny. At least he gives as good as he gets.
I wish you could complain occasionally. At least they would turn it down.
Oh, no, it's your family. You do your own dirty work.
Oh, some friend you turn out to be. You really are my best friend.
What brought that on?
Probably Jem.
Remember?
When you first met me, you gave me a pot of jam.
Well, I wish I could remember things like that.
And I also remember how you saved my marriage.
Rubbish. How are things between you and Max?
Oh, all right. I think I should have told him the truth about Danny.
You know my feelings about that.
It's probably what's wrong between them. Max must be wondering. Oh. Perhaps I have to tell him the truth one day.
Only me.
Hi, Mrs. Ramsey.
Hi, Scott.
You're early. How was dinner?
We didn't go to dinner. Where's Dad?
Next door.
He's doing the ceiling with Max.
Nice jam.
Danny's at home, if you want to go in.
Yeah, thanks. I think I will. See you later.
Hang on, man. I just did it in the middle here.
Where's that flaming kid gone?
It's okay, Max.
Danny! Get back in here!
No, I can manage, mate.
We shouldn't have to manage. It's his job. Danny!
Make your mind up. You told me to put the bloody kettle on, remember?
It doesn't take all night to put a kettle on. Now get that broom and hold that end up.
Hi.
I'm good, mate.
Where have you been all night?
Well, you had a date with the teacher's daughter. You should have seen him at the ice cream parlor.
Oh, look now what the boofhead's done! You can't even hold a broom against a bit of plaster, can you?
It wasn't his fault, Dad.
It wasn't his fault. Nothing's ever his fault. God help him if he ever tries to hold down a job.
I'll get a job. And when I do, I'm going to move out.
Oh, you're always promising. Listen, any time you want to go, you go. But you know where you'll end up? In the gutter with all the other deadbeats. Well,
anything would be better than this dump.
You're being a bit hard on young Danny, Max.
Look, I don't tell you how to handle your kids, Jim.
Always me. When does he ever yell at Shane?
When does Shane ever yell at him?
Yeah. Hey, you want to hear the edit we did on the old man and Mum?
Yeah, sure.
Eddie taped Mum talking to the old man and then him yelling at me. And we swapped it all around. Have a listen to this.
They ask if I will make some jam for the fate.
You're a drunker! You're no flame and good and you never will be.
You've got a sweet tooth. That's your trouble.
Don't you yell at me!
I think I'll ask Helen if we can make it next door.
You want to leave us? You leave us. It's bloody good riddance.
Oh, that's fantastic.
Yeah, wait till Mum hears it. And wait till you hear the one Eddie's working on right now.
I know, I know. Believe me, Mrs. Daniels, I won't even burden you with the way he's treating me. I thought, on the way over, I thought, I've inflicted too much of my husband's brutality on you and your family, and it's just got to stop.
Yes, yes, you're right. Yes. It has got to stop.
Hello, Mrs. Armitage.
Oh, hello, Mrs. Ramsey.
I'll be up home, Helen.
Oh, no, no, please don't go. I want to talk to you both.
It is rather late, Mrs. Armitage.
Oh, it's almost too late for some of us. That mongrel. You should have heard what he threatened to do to me tonight. You've always been so good to me, both of you, when I needed someone, but I know it just can't go on like this.
Oh, it can't.
I've always resisted leaving him because of the house, you understand. But someone's got to move, and it's obvious which one it has to be.
Oh, have you got somewhere to go?
No, I'm not moving anywhere. He's the one who has to be thrown on the pavement, bags and all. So if your husbands and boys would come right back with me now, we'll soon put some peace and quiet back into Ramsey Street.
Ah, now, just a minute, Mrs. Armitage. Are you suggesting our men help you kick your husband out of his house? Oh, it's just not on.
Why not? You've known for years that he belts me up.
Well, there's no way our families are going to get involved with some vigilante nonsense.
I see. You're both prepared to climb into your beds with my possible death on your conscience.
Oh, you do know how to strain a friendship. Now, come up here. That's right. Now, if you really want to do something about your husband, pick up the phone and call the police.
The police? I don't want them messing about in my private affairs. Thank you for your help. I don't think I'll bother you again. Good night. Good night, Mrs. Ramsay.
Good night.
Good night. Leave some life in.
And to think your husband got his knickers in a knot because a quiet little stripper moved into the street. Oh.
Hi. You in bed?
No. Just waiting for you.
For me? Why would anybody want to wait for me?
Would you like tea or coffee, a drink?
No, thanks. I guess we're not the only ones who fight a bit. You heard the Ramses as I walked by.
Some of it filtered through to here. Des, I'm sorry I upset you. It's the last thing I'd want to do.
Oh, no, it's my fault. The place looks great, really great. I appreciate what you did. Just with Lorraine and all this carry-on, it's just made me a bit wary about accepting favours.
So, we don't send the furniture back?
No. No, not unless we both muck in to pay for it.
Suits me. See you tomorrow, then.
There's just one small thing. Did Paul eat all that chicken? I am starving. Hello.
How'd you like your surprise?
Oh, Lorraine, how could you do such a rotten thing?
I moved some of it into my bedroom.
Yeah, I see. You're wallowing in comfort while I haven't even got a cushion to sit on, is that it?
That's it. Of course, if you're interested in discussing the return of the furniture, we could always negotiate.
Lorraine, could you do me a favour?
What's that?
Don't hold your breath.
Hey, Grandma, how's that shirt going?
Ready.
Want one of the papers, Scott?
No, thanks.
Are you going out today?
Oh, I might. I haven't made up my mind yet.
What about you, Paul? What are you doing?
Oh, I don't know yet.
Anything in the papers?
Lots of advertisements. Lucy, you sure you won't change your mind and come to the zoo with us?
No, thanks. I think I'll just hang around here for a while.
Grandma's just packing the hamper.
Oh, great. Well, you can help me get the car out. If you do change your mind and go out, make sure you lock the door.
Sure, okay. Have a nice time.
I always have a great time at the zoo.
So do I.
Hello. Are you sure you won't come with us?
Yeah, I'm sure. Have a good time.
They hang up?
It's important they'll obviously ring back.
Oh, it's probably one of those young idiots from school. I wouldn't mind if what they do is funny, but it's sordid. Should have seen the magazine I confiscated on Friday. Headmaster's too tolerant for some of those kids.
Well, I'll make an issue of it. Tell him.
Oh, I've told him. Thinks I'm too tough. Old-fashioned. I'd like to see him control that class of mine. It's all right for him sitting at his big desk.
Yeah. By the way, have you made a decision about Margaret yet?
Yes, let's take her to lunch. Poor beggar hardly ever gets invited out.
Well, do you mind if I don't come today, Mum?
Well, you know how your Aunt Margaret loves to see you.
I just don't feel up to going out today.
What's the matter? Don't you feel well?
I'm all right. I just feel like a day by myself.
See you later, okay?
See you later.
You got to stop spoiling me like this.
It's no trouble. Besides, I don't enjoy cooking just for myself.
Well, I'll tell you what, we'll make a deal. You do the cooking, I'll do the washing up.
Do you mean it?
Yeah. And just to show that I won't take advantage of you, we'll go to a restaurant every now and then.
I'd like that.
What are you going to do today?
You guys both decent?
What do you mean, decent?
I can see you're in a bit of mood today.
Would you like a cup of tea?
Yeah, sure, I'll get it. Listen, Daph, I was wondering if you'd like to come to the beach today.
That sounds like a good idea.
Yeah, okay, I will. Thanks, Paul.
What are you doing today, mate?
Well, I thought...
Oh, he's got a lot of washing up to do. Well, I'll be ready by the time you finish your tea.
Great. I can see you apologise to him, mate.
Apologise for what?
Oh, come on, you were like an ungrateful kid last night.
Okay, so I was like an ungrateful kid. Are you satisfied?
Yeah, I'm satisfied. Listen, you can come to the beach with us if you want, but I prefer you didn't.
Well... It's okay, I've got a lot
of... Anyone home?
Now, go away.
Good morning. Hey, this looks really great. Even better than it was before. The old man said that Daphne turned up with it in a van. Is it all hers?
It's ours. Des and I have an agreement.
How are you?
I'm fine, thanks. How's the training going?
Great, great. Hey, why don't you come with me today?
Sorry, Shane. Paul's just asked me to go to the beach. Some other time, though. I'd really like that.
Sure, sure. Anytime.
Well, you guys, have a nice day and we'll see
you. Yeah, see you both later.
Bye, Des. There's some cold meat in the fridge for your lunch.
Thanks. See you later.
I didn't hear you come in last night.
Ah, that's because I'm very considerate. You come in and wake up the whole household. Me, on the other hand, I'm very quiet, Sam.
What I'd call a quiet worker.
We had a great time at the zoo yesterday. Dad said he might get me a little dog for my next birthday.
Only if you look after it and take it for walks.
Right, I'm off. Scott, you'll have to take Lucy to school today.
Oh, Dad?
Oh, nothing. I'm running late already. You have a good time. I'll see you tonight. And don't fight with your brother.
But he doesn't want to take me to school.
Rise above it. See you, Mum.
Bye.
Bye.
Bye, Dad.
Are you ashamed of me? Is that it?
Yes.
In, are we?
Yeah. I'm really sorry about yesterday. I'd like to watch your train again.
Sure, why not?
Morning, Mr. Ramsay.
Morning.
Well, I'd better run. See you later. Hi. Have you had breakfast?
Yeah.
Oh, sorry, Des. I was hoping to be home in time.
Oh, this is your home, is it?
Yeah.
And you didn't turn up last night. I thought you might have moved out or something.
No, I just didn't come home, that's all.
Did you spend the night with Paul Robinson, did you?
No, I did not.
Then where were you?
Oh, hold on a minute, Des. That's got nothing to do with you.
Oh, I see. So next time you go out and you don't come home, I don't worry. Is that right? I mean, some of those loonies you strip for might be carving up in a back alley, but it's got nothing to do with me. I'll keep out of it.
Don't be like that.
Like what? Look, I know it's a bit square of me to expect you to phone whenever you're not coming home, but I'll know what to do in future. I'll know better next time.
If you must know, I didn't phone because I thought I might wake you up. Next time I will.
No, 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 forget it. You're right, it's got nothing to do with me. You live your life the way you want. I'm going out.
Hi.
Hi.
Sorry, I'm a bit late. I had to take my kid sister to school.
That's okay. What did you do yesterday?
Well, nothing much. I tried to ring you once.
About 9 o'clock?
Yeah.
We just got in from church. My mother answered it.
Yeah, I know. It scared the hell out of me. I was going to ask if we could get together.
I'll write that.
Next Saturday still okay?
Yeah.
Come on, we better go. You know what your mother's like if anyone's late.
Whatever's on the tape is obviously very funny. Can we share the joke?
No.
No? Let's hear it, Eddie.
It's just some crazy stuff, Mrs. Taylor. Just some stuff we did together over the weekend.
Sounds fascinating. Play it. Perhaps you realise just how unfunny your smutty humour is. Get ready to laugh, everyone.
I don't want to play the tape, Mrs. Taylor.
Do as you're told.
Oh, Scott, don't be like that.
I'm the school rapist.
This is what you brought me here for, isn't it? Sex.
Sure. How much was it again?
$10. I went to see a doctor to go on the pill.
Stop it. Switch it off.
Good neighbors, just a friendly wave each morning helps to make a better day. Neighbors need to get to know each other. Next door is open.